Dehancer Pro reached out to me to review their Dehancer Pro product for Adobe Premiere and DaVinci Resolve. Now, I'm a photographer, as you all know, and I'm kind of getting into this videography world. It's a lot of fun to do. Dehancer reached out to me and asked for me to do a review of their product, which was a great option for me to play with their product and see if the product was going to work for me. So here's my honest review of Dehancer Pro for all of you to enjoy. So let's just start out and say what I think of Dehancer Pro and if I think it's useful. And the answer is absolutely yes. This is a program that you can use to kind of make your stuff your own, right? So you can take your footage that you're capturing, making sure it's an S-log. That's something that I'm getting used to. But once you have that footage, you can then apply some of their amazing film effects to the footage to make it look old and atmospheric. There's something just romantic about that old film look. Dehancer Pro is a very easy tool to use as well. And once you get the thing installed, I find that you can use it to really, really pump up your footage easily, right? And you know, easily is relative because, you know, anything with regards to photography and videography can be challenging. So just keep it in mind relative to other products. I definitely think this is easy to use. So some of the really cool features that I liked with this tool were the ability to once again select many, many different cameras. I've been testing this with my Sony A1, my Sony A7 IV, which I'm shooting on today, and my Osmo Pocket. So I had a lot of old Osmo Pocket log footage that I pumped into this thing. And some of the footage that you're watching right now is of just that, using the Osmo Pocket and the Sony A1 out in the field once I got my hand on this tool. So there are many, many different cameras that this program supports. The Sony system and the Osmo, DJI Osmo system are just a couple cameras that it supports. Take a look. I bet, you know, if you're shooting with Canon, if you're shooting with Nikon, as long as your camera supports shooting an S-log or some kind of a log setting, you should be able to use this program to work for you. And it's relatively easy. Another big advantage of this tool is it really helps to keep your creativity flowing. As a photographer, when I'm working on an image, I never apply the same profile or same Lightroom setting to that particular image. I usually end up tweaking it. I find when I'm doing my video work, it's the same thing. I'm sending my videos into Adobe Premiere, and then I'm tweaking each video until I get my desired effect, because every video is going to be slightly different. The light's going to be different. The atmosphere is going to be different. And you know, there's going to be some fine tweaking. Sometimes I want the video footage to be cooler. Sometimes I want it to be warmer. It just depends on the mood that I'm trying to set. So this tool absolutely helps me to be able to get to a point where I can start tweaking those settings. And it's really, really easy to do. Now I will say, and once again, easy is relative, right? I've been doing this photography thing for a very long time. I know a lot about Photoshop, which is probably not very much, because Photoshop is a big, gigantic application that takes you years to learn how to use. And I probably know about 10% of it, right? When I say I know a lot of it, it's probably about 10%. Same thing applies to Adobe Premiere. Adobe Premiere is a beast of a tool. It's very, very big. You have to understand the inner workings of the Premiere tool, and you have to install this plugin on top of Premiere to get it to work. Another thing that I really like about this tool is that there are a ton of film emulation settings that you can apply to your footage, and I've only gone over a couple of them. I've been using the Kodak Portra settings for a long time in my photography work, kind of as a baseline, and then I tweak from there. And this Dehancer tool has all of the Portra settings built into this tool as well, so I can select the Portra settings if I want. I've been also playing with some of the Fuji settings, and even some of the other film emulation settings as well. And if you look at the footage, I'm giving you examples of some of the emulation settings that I've been applying. One of the things that I do like is that it's really easy to hover over a setting and scroll through all of the settings to see if a particular film emulation setting works. There are a ton of film emulation settings that are built into this program, and they start as a baseline because then you can further tweak those later on, doing things like halation, bloom effects, grain effects. It's very easy to tweak those film emulation settings to get that exact look and feel that you're looking for. So yeah, you can really, really, really dial down into the effects that you want to set and go from there. I think one of the biggest things that I love about this particular program, is that the footage that you get once you get there, the footage is beautiful, right? It almost feels like when I'm creating these scenes, I'm a film guy now, you know, and I feel like when I'm creating these scenes and I see the output, I understand the excitement and the allure of creating this type of video footage to really, really get something that I'm going to be proud of. And I will say, with all of these little clips that I've included in this particular review, after every single one of them, there was like this, I don't know, I can't explain it. There was just this joy that I felt at the end of every little clip. It's just a satisfaction knowing that I did something that I was proud of for each one of these clips. Very, very cool. This program absolutely does that. That old romantic cinematic film look is just really cool. So those are all the things that I really do like about this product. Now, there are a couple things that I did want to mention. Some of them are cons and some of them could be kind of, you know, I'm right on the edge. This product is not necessarily very cheap. It's not a cheap product, right? So we're talking $449 for a lifetime license. Now that's quite a bit of money. And the issue with that is that, you know, for $449, you know, you could lock yourself in, but are you really, really committed to using this type of tool over the lifetime of the tool, right? So that, you know, at that price, it's like you really, really should consider whether or not you're committed to use a product like this. Now they do have cheaper plans. They did have a 3-month plan for, it was $149 for 3 months. I think that's expensive as well. That does get you into at least playing with the tool and seeing if it's something that you would want to use. I believe they have a demo option as well where you can install it and they place a watermark on the video footage and you can still tweak everything just to kind of get a feel for how the product worked, which is great. But yeah, so $449 is expensive. And I will say, so it's this product is expensive, but you know, Adobe Creative Cloud is expensive and all the LUTs that you're gonna buy are expensive. This product allows you to tweak things. I pay for my music license for YouTube. I pay for other things for YouTube. So I mean, there's a lot of money that goes into producing something for YouTube. And you know, it can be very expensive. Is it a requirement? I don't think it is a requirement. There are people that are doing projects on YouTube much cheaper than a lot of people and they're doing well. So I don't think this is a requirement for being a YouTuber or making video footage for YouTube. So just keep that in mind. You know, is it worth the price? It's just something that you're gonna have to work out for yourself. Another thing, I don't think this is a particular con. I don't think we would be using products like this if we weren't serious about our videography or our photography work. But this product is not going to do the work for you, right? This is not one of those products that where you install it and there's an easy button and you kind of just click the easy button and all of a sudden you have cinematic footage, right? This product is designed for you to use it yourself to get to a place where you are happy with your footage. And anything you do, it doesn't matter if it's in Lightroom, Photoshop, Premiere, DaVinci Resolve, using the Dehancer tool. If your goal is to get to your final product the way you want to do it, there's gonna be a little bit of work that you're gonna have to do, right? You can borrow other people's Lightroom templates and kind of make them work for you if you want. I've seen many people do it. But you know, honestly, if you really wanna make something your own, you're gonna have to put in a little bit of work. This is no exception. This product will not do that for you. Oh, and one other thing that I wanted to mention, you need to be running a computer that can support both Adobe Premiere and the Dehancer plugin on top of it. About 2 years ago, I built a computer that was designed specifically for photography and videography use. And some of the components that I added to that computer was the GeForce RTX 4090 card. That is not a cheap card, but I really, really wanted to make sure that all of these components were going to give me a seamless photography and videography experience. So, can I say, I mean, I installed this application right on top of my computer and I've had no issues using Sony's highest camera settings for video. And I'm sending those right into Adobe Premiere and on top of that using this plugin to tweak those settings. And I've run into no issues to this point. So it seems to be working for me, and I've been dialing all kinds of things, you know, the grain settings, halation, bloom, selecting all these video profiles, you know, doing various other things, just kind of checking through to see what all these settings do. And I've had no problems. But I'd have to assume that if you're using a computer that is older or is running a slower video card, you might want to consider upgrading some of that hardware before starting to look into products like this, because you might find that these products can't keep up on the older architecture. So if you check out the description at the bottom of this page, you'll see that I have a code that'll save you 10% on this product. Code is Derek10. Check out the link in the comment. So I guess the bottom line is, will I be using this tool for video going forward? And the answer to that is absolutely yes. This is the type of thing I've been looking for. And I have to be honest, like in my photography journey, I was doing well, and the pandemic hit and things kind of slowed down. And when they slowed down, I had to get back on the horse. I was doing a lot of portrait work before the pandemic, and pandemic hit, and then I kind of took a break for 3-4 years. You know, the studio was open, but you know, I had maybe one or two people coming in. I mean, because it was hard, you know. So once the pandemic kind of switched over, I started working on the same stuff I was working on before, and which I love, by the way. I love the way I edit my photos, but I felt like I needed something new. So I've been looking at other techniques for photo editing, but you know, and then I started getting into video. And I think the fun thing about video is it's very similar to photography, but it is different. There's a lot of other things to understand and to learn. And I did make it a goal to try to get to that cinematic footage effect, you know, really trying to dial that in. So it's kind of where I'm going, and I'm really excited that Dehancer reached out to me at the perfect time, because this was a question that I was trying to answer for myself, is what can I do to take this video footage further? I'm more on the beginner side of this videography journey, but I definitely want to grow. So right now, I think that, you know, it's definitely where I'm focusing. But you know, at the end of the day, I'm a photographer at heart, and this videography stuff is a lot of fun, and I'm gonna try to keep both going for the time being. So stay tuned. So anyway, Derek Giofani signing out. Have a wonderful week, guys, and I'll talk to you next week.